Welcome back to Let's Play Grandia ReDux. I've made it back here in reasonable health, and like I said in the last part, they are, they do indeed come back. Yeah, it's quite a bit annoying, actually. Fix you. Did I pick up any spell breaks? Well, I bought a whole bunch more. Probably should have, picked up an extra one or two. Actually, I should have done this off screen. I apologize. Justin, you seem like the person to have heal. Nah, he doesn't really need it. Anyway, continuing on. This being the little gate area that I did not walk through before, I think. Yeah, there's stuff I haven't played with. I don't want to fight you. I do, however, want to pick up the gold. Anyway, I also went back and got a Gladius again for Fina, because I pretty much could not stand not being able to melee with her, so I fixed that. I actually had to go fight some lost souls again. That wasn't pleasant at all. But yes, I got the dagger, but granted, Fina's damage output is rather negligible. At least I still have my magic, which is a good thing. I'm really kind of getting irritated with all the things, though. The move block, especially on Sue, because Ra-Ra would actually be somewhat helpful. The damage output isn't that high, so Ra-Ra is actually quite nice in healing. But anyway, that's some more of that stuff, and a little bit of luck right there, but I'm not going to complain at all. Actually, probably better off just having Fina cast WoW. No. Since the damage return on somebody else is usually higher than her attacking. Meh. Although there is something to be said for the IP stun that she does inflict. Anyway, I need to fix up Justin a little. That's not who I want to do. I might as well do everybody now. Yeah, there is something to be said about the IP stun involved, though. So, Revival Stone. Which sounds like it's, a use in a revive someone, but it's not. It's actually, you know, if they're holding it and they die, they revive. Unless it's been changed. Which I severely doubt. I'm going to avoid you at the moment in efforts of making sure that I've picked up everything, which, you know, quite obviously I haven't. Doo-doo. I was also looking at the descriptions of my original playthrough of this and comparing how many episodes were the episode difference of where I am versus that, and it's only like 4. And that's all because of, you know, combat's taking a lot longer, and even though I'm not talking to everybody, it's still ending up at about the same amount as of parts, but it is taking a lot longer. Yes, you know what I think I'm gonna do? I'm gonna give Justin another block charm. And well, yeah, I've got a bunch of them, and actually give the majority of the resurrect items to Gadwin. I think that would be the thing to do. Really don't have many resu potions, do I? Oh, he's full. Great. Yeah, it's fine. I can deal with that. That's just the dead end. Now, I should be pretty much done here. Those are some of the dudes that I avoidified earlier on my way back. Because again, they do respawn if you leave, even only to the save point, which is kind of annoying. I have to say I was very unhappy when I came back and found out that all those dudes were back. But luckily they are quite easily avoided. I suppose the death charm isn't all that great since they don't seem to do it that often and it doesn't seem to work all that often either. But yeah, all that is pretty much moot at this moment. Yeah, get away from me. Ow. Jerks. Anyways, I don't think I can avoid these dudes, so I'm gonna kill them. Yes. Anyway, now that that's done, we get to talk to some Garlisle guys. Hello! Studying what? Sure. Although they don't notice that, three of us are completely human and Gadwin's not really a gumbo guy because he doesn't have a tail, and the gumbo people do. And it's more likely that they would act as guides versus, you know, someone from Dight. But, you know, I guess they don't get paid all that much and aren't really paying much attention. But, anywho, this is Stash Point, which, actually, might not need the, spell breaks for a while. I might regret this, but, I'm gonna plop them in anyway. Yeah, let's have Gadwin keep his. Yeah, I think that's all I want to do. Oh, that actually has recover. I'm amazed. I figured it wouldn't. But yes, there is quite the camp spread out. There's some tanks, which it kind of irritates me that you never fight, like, a tank. Or any of those kites that, you know, the flying things that he was talking about. But yeah, there's a whole bunch of dudes around here, tanks, etc., various tents that we can't really go into. And that's pretty much it. The whole goal is in the center right here. Watch out, Justin, it's them! What? Everyone just hide behind the tank. Cause it's, these three jokers. Unfortunately, we do not get treated to their music, which makes me a little bit sad. And, Justin, I believe they are out for your blood. Remember you? I don't think it's so much remembrance, more like want to get revenge. Yay for checking stuff out. Room of what? Teleportation? Temptation? Temptation. Yeah, there really isn't a whole lot over here. This looks like it goes somewhere, but it's a dead end. There's just a wall. So, it appears that there isn't anywhere to really go, since this just ends in a wall. Is there anything back here? No? Nah. So, that's pretty much it. All we can really do is leave, and there's Lane. Hello. To get ejected? As in, kicked out? But how do we get in? I mean, this can't be it. I mean, Pina? Sister? Yeah. Yes. Amazingly, he actually believes us. I mean, he wasn't like, yeah, you're lying, I don't believe you. No, he believes you. Actually, no, it's in my bank. At the moment. And it was all a trick. Oh noes, I hate tricks. Ew. And we're gonna fight Mullen. Apparently. And he pretty much pwns us without even getting into combat. I mean, one swipe and he took out Gadwin and almost took out Justin. That's a little bit melodramatic. It's just going no way. And Mullen is extremely confident with himself, and judging by what he just did, it's kind of justified. Listen to the green-haired one. The green stone in your pocket. Too bad it's in the stash at the moment. Apparently the spirit stone is the way in, even though technically I don't have it on me. And everyone who was standing on the platform has disappeared-ified. You're not going to find them there, so might as well just take care of Gadwin for the moment. At least you didn't land in the water and drown, Fina. And apparently poor Fina gets to hang out with Mullen. That was relatively quick. Good question. Don't know where Justin and Lean are at the moment, but we will join them soon. Yeah, despite the whole, you know, thing filling with water, and it's probably not very good for the paintings, they are actually in pretty good condition. One's the spirit stone, one's the spirits. Works for me. On our most wanted? Whoa. Really? You know, they do say they're twins, but I always get the feeling that Lean's a couple of years older. Maybe that's, you know, the forced maturity of being in the military. Since they are relatively young and Lean joined and forced maturity, blah, 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 blah. It's good that you're healthy enough to get mad. Mullen's taking the route of, you know, even though we're not exactly friends, at least in this situation, maybe we... Yeah, exactly. He summed it up better than I could. Yay! I can see that. And I bet Fina doesn't exactly feel all comfortable with, him holding her. Well, Gadwin's kind of on his back. Sue's perfectly fine, we know that, she doesn't. And, apparently we're joining young Justin. Not here. And there's some of the frog things. Unfortunately for us, it's only Justin. Thankfully, there is a recover option. I remember these guys in the original game being not even worth fighting. Now, I haven't a clue, but I can't imagine that they're too much more powerful. Because Justin is all by his little lonesome. 480. Let's whack them to see how much damage they take from physical. 113. Frog lullaby. I think this puts things to sleep. Which kind of stinks for me. Well, they really don't do much damage, so I'm not really afraid of that. Why not? Just to try it out. I want to see how much experience I get from it at the end of the fight, see if it's worth plugging out. And 74, I might as well just physical attack. You're defending, screw you, Mr. Bear. I'll just hit this guy. And he turns into, like, a Spiny from Super Mario Brothers. Which is really silly, to my opinion. And you just completely missed Justin. Yeah, so I'm not really afraid of these guys. Although, I believe there's groups of four later. That's my three, relatively painful. And they drop something, apparently. Yellow pill. Don't really give much experience or gold. 8 experience for fire. I might want to use some fire just to get some experience if they're close enough together to hit to both of them. But, yeah. I have to deal with lots of them. I will not show any of this. I'm pretty much not going to get ambushed because it's only Justin. And Justin learns that all. I'm pretty much just spamming burn on them since the burn experience seems quite nice for him. The fire experience, rather. And Justin learned fire burner. I'm actually spamming boom now. Because, well, I'm just kind of taking advantage of it. But, unfortunately for me, I am kind of flying through my MP, but then again, save points right over there, so, meh. Alright, that absolute huge mess has finally been dealt with. As you can see, I've gone through a lot of MP, and apparently I got another, level of water. But yeah, I actually gained, like, 2 levels on Earth, 3 on fire. Actually not a bad return for just kind of killing really easy enemies. It's a nice little bonus for Justin. Unfortunately for everybody else, they have to actually earn theirs in, you know, battles that might actually be difficult. Anyway, there's going to be a bunch more frogs. That's not one group, that's 4. And I shall kill these as well. Alright, oh, there's one more. Never mind. Okay, that should take care of the rest of them. They also drop, they drop yellow pills, which I've gotten quite a lot of, and, also a raincoat, which prevents falling asleep. I actually want to use that. They kind of do plop that out. It's kind of going to help me more than the block charm is at the moment. Not that these guys are really all that threatening. I mean, they're really susceptible to defense loss too, so you could just defense loss them, then melee them. Because right now I'm doing like 150 damage that way. Because the way I am now, it pretty much automatically puts on -7 to them. So, yeah. Yeah. It's unfortunate for them, fortunate for me. Eek! And Lean is getting attacked by frogs. Apparently she has a major problem with frogs. Anyway, I'm going to pick up this gold, even though you can't see me, and next time we will actually save Lean, since she does seem afraid of frogs. Until then. And I like this music. Haha.